I'm Sheri Fink, and I write books that inspire and delight kids while planting seeds of self-esteem. And I wasn't always a writer. I actually started doing this about 2 years ago when I was at a conference and a woman asked me about my writing, and I said, oh, I've just got business and marketing, you know, for my career. And she said, no, I feel like you've got more. And she kept pushing me, and I reluctantly said, I have this story about a little rose that grows up in a weed bed and thinks that she's the weed. And she said, oh, I just got goosebumps. You have to do something with that because my grandchildren need that message to accept and love themselves. And I said, oh, And then she introduced me to everybody at the conference as a children's writer. And at first I was like really awkward, like, no, that's not me. Like, there's a misunderstanding. Because I didn't even realize it was a children's story. I had it in a drawer for many years. And so when I got home, I was like, wow, nobody laughed when they said that about me. And maybe I could do this. So what does it take to publish a children's book? I have no idea. So I started reaching out to people who had done things like that and attending writers' conferences like the Southern California Writers' Conference and learning all the bits of information that I needed. And once I learned about traditional versus independent, I made the strategic decision to go straight to independent because I'm an entrepreneur. And I thought, well, let me give it a go. So it's just been amazing. Well, I would ask people how they did it and what they liked, what they didn't like about the process, what they would do differently, and what they recommended to me. And then I would say, is there anyone else that you think I should talk with? And would you introduce me? And so I ended up having all these great calls with these amazing people who were very generous with their time and encouraging. And I did everything that they told me to do. You know, I hired a printer, I hired an illustrator, I bought my ISBNs, I did my copyright, everything. And then 2 weeks after my book came out, it became a number one bestseller on Amazon, which was amazing. This weekend, I had the privilege of giving back to the writers community that has benefited me over the last 3 years, when I got to share my story and give a workshop about how to become a best-selling independent author. So it was really fun, and I enjoyed sharing some of my strategies that I've actually never shared before. So it was a delight. Oh, I highly recommend them, because that's where you meet the people. That's where they're the most accessible. That's where you're going to get the nuggets that you wouldn't be able to find in a book or online or in a blog. Mm-hmm. And you just never know. You meet the most fascinating people. You hear their stories. You get inspired. You get strategies. And even now, I took pages and pages of notes. Highly recommend it. Learn as much as you can. Get information from people who have done it the way that you want to do it. And go with your heart. I mean, trust your instincts. If something feels like it's off, it's off. Mm-hmm. Don't question it, just next. You know, find the right partners, find the right printer, you know, ask around, get references, always get references. Mm-hmm. And if they are not like amazingly happy, then keep moving. You know, you'll find the right partners and you can do it. Well, I asked everybody that I knew, who do you know who illustrates books or maybe would be interested in illustrating books or went to art school or would just have a chat with me about this project? And I ended up with 8 names, friends of friends of friends, and it ended up being someone in my mastermind group, actually. He said, I have a guy who has a guy for everything. He said, I needed to cover a 30-story building in Talis with a tarp once, and he had a guy for that, so I'll ask him. And he ended up being the one that introduced me to my illustrator. So I interviewed all of the 8 leads. I gave them the story. I told them, you know, I really want it to feel hopeful, even in the parts that are like the big gloom, you know? And I really want it to be a joyful book. And then I got these samples back. I asked for a concept drawing from each of them. And some of them made me want to cry, but not in a great way. So I said, okay, that's not the right person for me. Some folks, they didn't hit the deadline, so that was a very good project and awareness to know, okay, they're not ready for this project. But Mary, my illustrator's Mary Erickson Washam, she gave me thumbnail sketches of the entire book, just little sketches, and I fell in love. And I said, whatever it takes, I have to work with this woman. She is amazing. And she captured the feeling that I wanted in that book so beautifully. Better than I could even articulate it. So then I was like, okay, what's it going to take to work with you? And now we're currently illustrating the 4th book. So great. Yes, it's a great partnership. There's a series, the little series, and that started with the little rose, then the little gnome, and then we have the little firefly coming out in March. And then I have one for the younger kids, the 2 to 5 year olds, that's coming out in 10 days. that's Exploring the Garden with the Little Rose, and that's a garden adventure, but it's an alphabet vocabulary book. I would say the biggest one is that you have to really, you have to be willing to ask for what you want, always. Don't settle for less than you want or deserve, and that comes with working with partners. It comes with working with the media, and never be entitled, but always ask from the heart about what you actually want, because that's the only way you're going to get it, because people can't read your mind, and you have to really take ownership over the process. So if you have a deadline, like, you have to run it like a business. So you know that in order to be in Amazon by a certain date, it has to be done at the printer and then done. Like, you just need to go backwards and set your deadlines and be very firm with everybody that you work with and explain to them how important it is that it be done by that date. And usually if people understand that, they'll do whatever it takes to get it to you. But that's something I've definitely learned by having a couple of very stressed out moments. but it's totally doable. It just, you have to plan it like a business and treat it that way with the respect that it deserves. Clarity is everything in what you want for your book, for what you want it to look like, feel like, and the way that you want to be perceived in your brand out in the world. Like, you have to be very clear. What do you stand for? Mm-hmm. What is the mission that you want to support? And then align everything else you do around that.